The biosecurity focus came for us in 2014 when the cucumber green mottle mosaic virus turned up in Catherine on some melon farms, on our big melon farms. And it actually sat there for a month or two before it was diagnosed as a different virus from ones we'd had for many, many years and the people were quite comfortable with managing. That then created a fairly quick and intense response from the regulators, from the quarantine guys. And it certainly put on notice all the cucurbit production in the Northern Territory.
When we first heard about it, we were terrified, of course, because you don't know if you are or aren't infected, and they were sending people out to inspect everybody, and you don't know what it's supposed to even look like, because it looks like a lot of other diseases. It's not specific design. It doesn't have anything particular that it looks like. It's when the fruit is cut that you can notice it. Until you realize, okay, it's a bit pale, the plant doesn't look very, it looks a bit sickly, but that's five or six other diseases that they look sickly. So it was very, very difficult.
That was scary. It was scared me a bit, and then I was taking action in biosecurity in my farm, so make sure everything, you know, I don't want to bring the virus into my farm here. Yes. Every day it's the same thing. Even we come out for half an hour, 1 hour, whatever, we still do the same thing. I will do this for the rest, like until the day I stop farming. It could be big trouble if the virus spread more and more. It could pass farm to farm, especially the farm, you know, where the area, a lot of farm, you know, next door to it. It could happen, you know, like overnight, if you not take caution on it. I don't want to take any risk in here, so I keep on doing what I'm doing right now.
Be vigilant, because that's what we have to do. We go through, if we see a plant that looks poorly, sickly, turning yellow, spotting on the leaves and stuff like that, immediately pull it out so that the roots and the vines don't touch another plant. Be vigilant right from the start. Pull it out. Sacrifice one plant rather than a whole row, because any given day, if I'm shut down today and all my loads that are on the way are shut down, I'm looking at, and I'm a small grower, I'm looking at maybe 10 loads, which is 20 ton a load, on the road to the market being dumped. And we've already paid to pick it, we've bought cartons for it, we've done, and this is how it was, that we've bought the cartons for it, we've picked it, we've packed it, we've freighted it, and it's on the road. What do? And you have to pay somebody at the other end, either pay double freight to get back, or pay somebody at the other end to dump it with a huge dumping fee. No, it was prohibitive. And there are people that went to the wall.